Staphylococcus aureus is a gram-positive bacterium that is about 2 micrometers in size and can be found on the skin of about 30% of the population. Although often benign, it can cause endocarditis, toxic shock syndrome, skin infections, sepsis, and other illnesses. Staphylococcus aureus is also a common foodborne pathogen found in meat and meat products. Widespread methods to preserve foods are the use of excess amounts of sugar or salt to dehydrate the products. This can prevent bacterial growth and hence the transmission of food spoilage organisms. Staphylococcus aureus, however, is exceptionally resistant to high salt concentrations and therefore can survive these processes better than many other organisms. Recent work in Staphylococcus aureus has revealed a second messenger called cyclic diAMP that interacts with several proteins that target early salt tolerance genes. These are KTRA, a potassium transporter, KDPD, a sensor histidine kinase potentially involved in potassium uptake, CPAA, another protein supposedly involved in cation transport, but also PSDA, a protein of unknown function. In our recent study, we were able to identify an additional target of cyclic diAMP in Staphylococcus aureus, the ABC transporter component, OpuCA. The OpuC-ABC transporter consists of OpuCA, the ATPase component that provides energy for the transport, OpuCB and OpuCD, the main transporter components involved in translocation of the substrates, and OpuCC, the substrate binding protein responsible for the specificity. This transporter is supposedly involved in the uptake of osmolytes, and this can help Staphylococcus aureus to cope with osmotic stresses. Binding of cyclic diAMP occurs via the CBS domain of OpuCA, and this binding is specific for nucleotide cyclic diAMP. Other nucleotides, such as ATP, AMP, or cyclic AMP, are unable to outcompete binding of cyclic diAMP. With the help of X-ray crystallography, we were able to elucidate the structure of OpuCA as depicted here. By comparison to MJ01000, a structurally related protein colored in blue, we can make educated guesses where cyclic diAMP could be binding. Exchange of important amino acids and subsequent binding testing revealed that a proposed binding site is likely the functional region. Further experiments revealed that the OpuC transporter is able to transport carnitine, whereas glycine betaine and choline are not taken up in significant amounts. When cyclic diAMP levels were increased in the cell, the uptake of carnitine was reduced compared to wild-type cells. Taken together, our research highlights the role of cyclic diAMP as a regulator of osmotic stresses. This knowledge may help in the future to prevent foodborne Staph aureus infections. More information can be found in the paper, The Second Messenger Cyclic diAMP Inhibits the Osmolyte Uptake System OpuC in Staphylococcus aureus, by Schuster and Bellis et al., published in Science Signaling, Volume 9, Issue 441, on August 16, 2016. Thank you for watching.